Hello, I'm Bernadette Castro. Integrity, service, hard work, and dedication. These are just some of the lifelong values the Catholic schools instill into every student. Long after they graduate, alumni feel the deep calling within that draws them to help others or to simply do the right thing in difficult situations. If a person's life were a pond, our educators would be a tossed stone that creates lasting ripples of virtue and compassion. Men and women raised through Catholic education are shaped into selfless, caring adults. It's impossible to fully measure the enormous impact on society that our schools have had over the generations. So join us this episode as our guests reflect on their experience at Catholic schools and how it shaped their lives for the better, proving once again that today's children are tomorrow's hope. If you've tuned into our show recently, you may be familiar with our next guest, who so generously reported from the field for us. As both a Catholic school graduate and now a teacher at Kellenberg Memorial High School, she's no stranger to the concept of giving back to the next generation of students. Her strong commitment to the mission of the Tomorrow's Hope Foundation helps ensure that every child is given the opportunity to learn. Please welcome Peggy York. Peggy, thank you so much for being
here.
Thanks
for having me.
So you almost look like you should be in high school.
I get that a lot. You know, luckily my students wear uniforms, so there's a distinct differentiation between us.
And what do you teach at Kellenberg?
I teach freshman scripture. So we teach the Old Testament and the New Testament.
Wow. I'd like to sit in on one of those classes.
It's fun. We've really had the curriculum grow a lot over the last few years, and it's a great course, and I'm very proud of it. So,
but you know, that's what's so beautiful about Kellenberg and the Catholic high schools. I mean, that would not really be possible in any other school system.
No, absolutely not. And we've really been able to take what we want to teach, and we have the ability to expand on certain things and really cover other options within the Bible and things like that. So it's great.
And you went to Catholic school.
I did, yes. I went to Curia of Ours in Merrick for nursery through first grade. And then when we regionalized, I went to St. Elizabeth Ann Seton in Belmore from second through eighth. And then I went to Kellenberg from 9 through 12. So.
And here you are teaching.
And I'm back.
And here you are helping us with this wonderful TV series. And thank you for your field reports.
Oh, absolutely. It's been fun. And it's been great meeting all the little kids out there. I love teaching high school. But I do like seeing the little ones, too. They're cute. So.
Well, thank you so much.
Absolutely.
Also, you and I have bonded,
okay, yes.
Over auctions.
Yes.
You know, your dad started this beautiful gala every year to raise funds for the Tomorrow's Hope. And we do our auction together, and we're kind of tag teaming.
Yep. Even the other day when someone saw us together, they were waiting for us to start the auction.
Yeah. So we also, together, became star donors.
Yes.
Explain what a star donor is.
So a star donor is someone who basically helps fund the tuition of a student, a specific student for the year. And like we have a little boy at St. Martin's who we get letters from and we get Christmas cards, and it's great. And you know, it's a wonderful opportunity to be able to help these children go to Catholic school and also see them grow. You know, because you do get your reports and you get little cards and things.
No, so that fee, not to be businesslike about it, but it's $2,000, and you help fund, I think, about 50% of the tuition.
Yep.
And what's nice is that, you know, I put my credit card in and I take out so much a month over so many months, and so you really don't
feel
the impact.
You, you can do it up front if you want, but you can absolutely spread it out, which, like you said, is helpful and nice.
Yes.
So.
You know, you're a great young woman and you're extremely well educated. You could have chosen any school to teach in. Why did you want to teach at Kellenberg?
Okay, so a little backstory. When I was little, I always wanted to be a teacher. Always. From when I was a little girl, and my dad will joke that I would line my toys up and I would teach them. I mean, I was the girl who liked going to the teacher's store at like 8 and getting a book. But so I always wanted to be a teacher. And when I started going to Kellenberg, I remember being like, I want to come back and teach here. And my parents were very supportive of it, but they were like, you know, see where your life takes you. And I went to college, got my degree in education, and I did some observing at Kellenberg. And I loved it. And so I was offered my position there. I was actually originally a math teacher at Kellenberg. And then as the years went on, Brother Kenneth asked me to teach scripture, which I love, as I said before. But Kellenberg is a unique environment. We are a school, but we're a family. And I have so many friends from when I used to go to Kellenberg that I'm still friends with. My husband, I met while teaching there. He is also a graduate of the school. I did not know him when we were students, but I met him when we started teaching there. And so many of my fellow faculty members are my closest friends, but the students too. They become your family and they become your children. And I feel that I have some sort of parental permission with them because they are mine. They're my kids and I love them, and they're different. Our students are they're just amazing. They're awesome. Like, I can't say enough about them.
Oh, that's wonderful.
I love waking up and going to work.
That's
every
great.
Morning.
So. You know, as you think about all the parents out there mm-hmm. that are trying to make this decision, mm-hmm. do I put my child in Catholic school? Or do I put my child in, you know, the public school
yeah.
system? Or do I consider another private
right.
system? If you were going to say to them, choose Catholic school, what would be your strongest reason?
Well, I would say there's a bunch, but I would say definitely you get such an amazing education. You become a well-rounded human. You become an educated person. You become a faith-educated person. Your faith grows so much. I have so many students. I have a graduate that just I can think of right off the top of my head who was amazing at Kellenberg, has gone on to go to Catholic University, and he's a freshman, and he's already attending. He's going to World Youth Day this summer for as a representative of Catholic. He's only a freshman. He's going on a mission trip. He's involved there in so much. And I really think that Kellenberg gave them the basis for that. So I would say that. And I would say that it's yeah. just an amazing environment. It's a great place to grow. And so I would say to any parent looking to do it, it's the choice.
Well,
it's
thank
the right
you.
One. Absolutely.
Thank you so much for being here today for this interview, but more importantly for other volunteering of time.
Of course.
For
yeah.
those wonderful field trips that you're doing to the various schools.
Absolutely.
We thank you so very much.
You're welcome.
We'll be right back with more, but first, did you know? 99% of Catholic secondary school students graduate, and 86% go on to four-year colleges, compared to 40% of public school graduates who go on to a four-year college. This overwhelming commitment to learning speaks to the positive impact that a Catholic education can have. Welcome back. The true value of a Catholic education isn't measured in simple test results or grades, but in the fullness of a student's character after graduation. Here with us now is a reflection of that important fact are two Catholic school alumni, Alicia Jabbour McCrudden and Kevin McCrudden. Welcome, you two, and thank you so much.
Thanks for having us.
Look at this. Isn't this romantic? I love it.
We don't get to spend too much time together, so we'll take this moment.
But, I mean, I think it's great. I mean, you know, I've known of you, Mr. and Mrs. Motivation. And so, you know, talk to me about what that means, Kevin. What is that?
After 9/11, I had a National Day of Recognition passed by Congress called National Motivation and Inspiration Day, and the name of my company is Motivate America. So when in my speaking business, I'm referred to as Mr. Motivation, America's CMO, Chief Motivation Officer.
Love it.
So what we did is we branched off of that, and we created a radio show called Mr. and Mrs. Motivation, and that's where we focus on relationship-based stuff.
So both of you went to Catholic school. So tell me, Alicia.
12 years at St. Mary's in Manhasset. I started first grade and graduated after 12 years. And I have to say, how many people do I run into from St. Mary's?
All over the world.
All over the world.
In Paris, in Rome, we run into people from St. Mary's.
Yeah, I mean, what a great education, great faith-based education that my parents chose for us. And if I can say that the one gift that our parents have given both of us is that of faith.
Absolutely.
Right?
Yeah, huge.
Yeah. And certainly one thing about education, you know, you can lose things along the way of life, right?
Yeah.
We can lose a career, we can lose a little money, but we never lose the education. No one can ever take that away. And that's why these decisions are so critical. So, Kevin, do your kids, how many children do you have?
We have three children together, a 27-year-old, a 19-year-old, and a 17-year-old. And the 17-year-old, Mary-Kate, is currently at Our Lady of Mercy in Syosset.
Wonderful.
We have a son at Fairfield, who is a graduate of St. Anthony's.
Wonderful.
So, yeah.
So Catholic, second generation, moving right along.
Yeah. Absolutely.
That's great. So, you know, was there a conscious decision in putting the children in Catholic school? Was it based on your experience, or was it also kind of seeing what else was out there? And, you know,
I think for me, it made total sense because I didn't know anything different, to be perfectly honest. So,
right.
You know, when I was a member of the parish, went up, you know, how do I enroll the kids? It didn't seem any different for me. And people ask me that, what about your school system? And it is an excellent public school system. But for me, I was brought up with a faith-based school curriculum, and that was very important to me. And I see how important it is as an adult to have that faith-based education. So it made total sense, I think, for both of us.
Yeah, and I think on Long Island, we're so fortunate because so many of our Catholic schools are college preparatory schools. So they really prepare them for life. They prepare them for college, which is excellent.
And our son, Harrison, who's at Fairfield University, which is a Jesuit school, when we were looking at colleges while he was at St. Anthony's High School, he was like, of course I want to go to a Catholic college.
I love
so
it.
How awesome is that?
That is very, very
we
awesome.
We really weren't infusing the air with it, you
yeah.
know, obviously.
Yes.
You know, it was his choice, but certainly made a big, big decision for him.
Well, listen, I thank you both for being here. And we're going to watch Mr. and Mrs. Motivation on our screen, right? Because we can see you, or no, just hear you?
Just audio right now.
Oh, so you can do it in your pajamas?
Yes, absolutely.
Pajamas.
Absolutely.
We have a great picture of it. You can see us on the picture.
Yeah.
Well, you make a beautiful appearance. I think, you know, you never know. We got to get you started here on video.
Thanks
so much
Thank
for
you.
Being here.
Thank you, Bernadette.
If you're watching at home and considering sending your child to a Catholic school, don't just take my word for it. See what these satisfied parents have to say.
We always wanted to raise our children in a Catholic environment, so selecting Catholic school for us was fairly easy. Once we started, we were very happy, we were very pleased with the families that we met, with the education that they were receiving, and the kind of people that they were becoming.
As soon as I opened the door, it just felt like I got a hug. So it was definitely a feeling that I felt at first, and after viewing the classes and seeing what they did here with the technology, their courses, the extracurricular, that they offered sports all the way from pre-K up, it was a fit.
My children have wonderful role models at the school. The teachers are wonderful. They pretty much teach my children all the things that my husband and I give to them at home. Good values, good morals, to be kind to other people, to give back.
It's everything. I think what their foundation that they receive here, their integrity, the morality, everything that they don't get in that public school setting, which I've experienced for my children, they get at Catholic school.
I feel very happy and very pleased, both my husband and I, that the children make very good conscious decisions and how they are with other people, how they behave. I think they stand out.
We definitely excel, I'd have to say, in education and the technology, but what they get when they're praying, when they're together with their classmates, when they go to Mass together, you don't get that anywhere else but here, but at Catholic school.
The children will obtain a good education, that's for sure. I think there's a lot more that they are going to get that they will not get elsewhere, and that is the values that they're going to learn, the faith that they're going to have, the respect that they're going to have for themselves, for others, and the love of God.
We'll be right back after this, so stay tuned. Everyone. Many graduates of Catholic schools go on in life to do amazing things, and our next guest is no exception. She's the author of the best-selling Regan-Reilly mystery series. She's an actress and a good friend. Please welcome Carol Higgins Clarke. Carol, thank you for coming.
Thank you, Bernadette, for having me.
I'm so excited. I mean, I just look at your books that we've sort of piled up around you, and I'm just so proud of you. You're just fabulous.
Oh, well,
and
thank
what
you.
I what I want to say about your books, first of all, generically, is that they're Nancy Drew for grown-ups. I love them. I was a Nancy Drew fan when I was a little girl, and then I read your book, and it's wholesome, and it's a light, wonderful mystery, no bad language. I have five granddaughters, and they could read every one of your books, so I'm just so proud of you.
Well, thank you, Bernadette, and it was the way I met you, which was so great.
Oh,
my
yeah,
first
tell that
book,
story.
Decked, I have Regan accompanying a woman on a cruise ship whose helper had to cancel, and they get to the suite, and there's one bed, and Regan looks at the couch and thinks, I hope that's a Bernadette Castro special. So
exactly. Let me finish the story now.
Okay.
So one of my friends was reading your book, and I get this call in my office at Castro Convertibles, and she said, you're in a book. And I went, what do you mean I'm in a book? And so I said to my assistant, find the author, call the publisher, I have to meet her.
Yeah, and I didn't know when I wrote your name like that, we'd end up being such good friends, which is great.
It is great. And you know, I thank you for taking time from your crazy schedule. First, let me say, I know there's a new book coming out. I don't have it yet. I tried to buy it and it's not out. Tell us a little bit about that book.
It's called Knocked. All my titles are one word ending in ED because the first book was Decked. And then I wrote about a murder at a pantyhose convention. So I said, if that was Decked, this should be Snagged. So that's all my one word titles came from that. And in the new book, Regan goes back to her 10th reunion at college. And there are two women who are 102, the only two left in their class. And the college put them in the infirmary, which makes them mad because they want to be in a dorm having fun. And they leave to go for dinner, but they're kidnapped. So
wow.
Regan is, the whole college is trying to find them and get them back.
That's so cute.
Yeah.
So I think, Carol, one of the reasons you write such wonderful, wholesome books is you come from such a good Catholic background. And your mom was such an influence. And by the way, we should mention your mom.
Yeah. Mary Higgins Clarke,
yes. Mary Higgins Clarke, a wannabe famous mystery writer.
Right.
She's got a brilliant career and has had for decades.
Yes.
But your Catholic education, could you tell us a little bit about that?
Oh, well, I went to Catholic Grammar School, Our Lady of Good Counsel in Washington Township, New Jersey. And then I went to Immaculate Heart Academy for high school. And all my brothers and sisters went to Catholic schools as well. My brothers went to St. Joe's in high school in Montvale. And it was just my parents wanted us to have a Catholic education. They both did. And they saw such value in it. And
you know what's interesting to me, too, knowing a little bit about your personal story, if you don't mind me sharing it. But your dad died when you were 8 years old. And
right.
How many children were there in the family?
Five.
Five. And your mom was a single mom. You
yes.
were eight,
mm-hmm.
and I think she started writing books, hoping to make it with one book. But she was had to be somewhat challenged financially, and
oh.
yet she chose Catholic school.
Oh, yes. She didn't have her first suspense novel published until I was in college. So raising us, it was a long time after my father died before she became a successful writer. But she still wanted to make the sacrifice to send us to high school. Was more expensive, of course, than grammar school, but
right.
It was something that she really wanted to do.
I also know that you had a favorite nun. So tell me about her.
My first grade teacher I loved, Sister Rosita. She was so nice, and I used to go up to her desk and tell her jokes that
like?
I saw. Like, is your refrigerator running? And she'll go, yes. And I said, why don't you go catch it? And she'd laugh. And she'd laugh every time, even if I told her the joke twice. But she was just really so caring and kind. And it was a great start to my Catholic education because I just really loved her. And years later, she left after my first grade. I was so sorry she was gone from the school. And years later, I met up with her again. And I spoke at the school for the kids that she was teaching all these years later.
Wow.
So that was fun.
That's wonderful. The spirituality that that you learned, I mean, how has that helped you in your career?
Having a faith and believing in God and so much of what I was taught there at Catholic school. It helps you get through the bad times, and it just becomes a part of who you are, really. And it's part of your soul.
Oh, that's so true. So if you were going to, you know, talk to parents, young parents, about making choices, because, you know, that is a serious choice that a parent makes. Do mm-hmm. I put my child in Catholic school, public school, or perhaps another private school? Mm-hmm. What would you say to them? How would you advise them?
Well, I think the Catholic schools instill wonderful values in kids, and not that there aren't good other schools, but right. Catholic schools do, you know what you're going to get when you go there, and that your kids will get a good education. No matter what, you get a great education there. I remember the nuns were always such good teachers, and really prepares you for high school and then for college. So I would advise them to send their kids to Catholic schools if they can.
Well, I love that. And I think you're an inspiration to writers. Mm-hmm. To, you know, I hope a lot of young people watch this interview mm-hmm. to understand that there can be a great future for them. And mm-hmm. You're an inspiration. Yeah. And I thank you so much for being with us today,
Oh, well,
Carol.
Thank you, Bernadette.
I can't wait to read that new book.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. During this past half hour, listening to our guests talk about the value of a Catholic education has been inspiring. Decades ago, Bishop Fulton Sheen said something which I've always loved, and his message still applies today. He intended his words to describe the whole Catholic Church, but they are so relevant right now and are another way to describe the value of Catholic elementary schools. He said, "The world today is tearing up the photographs of a good society, a good family, a happy individual personal life. But the church is keeping the negatives. And when the moment comes when the world wants a reprint, we will have them." Catholic elementary schools keep those beautiful photographs of a good society, a good family, a happy individual personal life in front of students on a daily basis. Images come alive. Lessons learned in those classrooms stay with those young people, as you saw for yourself today, for their entire lives. Thank you for joining us. And always remember that today's children are tomorrow's hope.